Yes, brother in the red, mic 3.
I am from Karnataka, Hubli. I am doing job as a manager as a medical distributor. My question is, where is dead one? What happened to them? Thank you.
Sorry, I didn't get a question. You are, where is the one and what happened?
Where is the dead one? Where what happened to them?
Where is the?
Dead one. Jo mar gaye.
Dead person.
Dead one. Yeah, ah. Dead. Brother asked the question, where are the dead people and what has happened to them? I heard dead one, bed one, I'm wondering what was. So what, where are the dead people, what happened to them? As I mentioned in my earlier answers, that Allah has created death and life. Allah says in Surah Mulk, chapter number 67, verse number 2, Allazi khalaqal mauta wal hayata. Allazi. That Almighty God has created death and life to test which of you is good indeed. So this life is the test for the hereafter. Now once a person dies, his test is over. Test is finished. But the results of all the human beings, from the first human being on the face of the earth, from Adam, peace be upon him, till all of us that are living, as well as till the last human being going to live, all will be resurrected on the day of judgment. And the results will be declared together. You know how we have, you know, for example, here we are voting. Voting takes place in North India, separate date, South India, separate date, East India, separate date. But the counting starts together and the results are declared together. So similarly here, this test has taken place. But the Malik Yawmuddin, he is the master of the day of judgment. The day of judgment will be together. Hisab Kitab. Who's right, who's wrong will take place together, and then depending upon your good deeds or bad deeds, have you obeyed the commandments of the Prophet, the commandments of Almighty God or not, you may go to heaven or hell. So all of us would be resurrected. At present, they are dormant. Dormant, that means they have died, but they'll be resurrected. Almighty God will give them life again on the day of judgment. So all the human beings will be resurrected. And on the day of judgment, Allah says in the Quran, in Surah An'am chapter 6, that no one would object to the justice of Almighty God. Because our organs will be our witness, our eyes will give witness, our hand will give witness about ourselves. So even those who will be put in hell, if they have not followed the commandments, the Quran says, they will not object to the justice of Almighty God. They will say, give us one more chance, and Almighty God will say, it is too late. The exam is over. So on the day of judgment, all be resurrected. Depending upon a good deed, bad deed, you will pass or you will fail. You will go to heaven or hell. Hope that answers the question, brother.
Yes, sister, in mic 1.
Good evening, sir. My name is Sejal Yadav. My question is, sir, the Muslim brethren in India, why do they refrain from saying Vande Mataram? And what is the reason? I mean, Vande Mataram is a thing which symbolizes Indian nationalists and doesn't have a religious identity.
Sister, were you there yesterday? You were there in the program?
No, sir.
Because this question was asked by another sister yesterday, but since you were not yesterday, I repeat my answer. The sister asked the question that why do Muslims refrain from saying Vande Mataram? Before I give the answer why do Muslims refrain, I would give some advice that even the Hindus should refrain. Why? Because it goes against the scriptures. As I mentioned earlier, in the earlier answer when our Sikh brother, he asked the question, I gave you quotations from Upanishad, from Veda, that Almighty God should worship Him alone and no one else. He has got no images. Now Vande Mataram is a song in which thrice it says that Vande Mataram, I bow down to my motherland. Now in Hinduism you worship only Almighty God and no one else. God is the creator of this country also. Fine? So it goes against your scriptures. And Hinduism is against idol worship. Hinduism says you bow down only to Almighty God and no one else. You worship Him alone, no one else. So besides Muslim, first I would like to say, it goes against the Hindu scriptures. You ask any Hindu scholar, if you ask a layman or a laywoman who is unaware of the Hindu scriptures, they may not know it goes against. Coming to nationality, I'll tell you afterwards. As far as Muslims are concerned, again this verse, Vande Mataram, it goes even against the Quran. Because in Islam, we worship only Almighty God and no one else. And this country India, we Muslims, we love the country, we respect the country, we follow the laws of the country. As long as the law of the country do not go against the law of the Creator Almighty God, we have no objection in following any law of any country. But if the law of the country contradicts against the law of Almighty God, then we don't follow. So Almighty God is the creator of this country. So who should be bound, to the country or to Almighty God? As far as India is concerned, most of us Muslims, we love the country, we respect the country. If required for the truth, we are ready to die for the country, but we will not bow to the country. Why? Because it goes against the law of the creator. Similarly, no Saudi should bow to Saudi Arabia also. Don't think this is only by Indian Muslims. In Saudi Arabia, a Saudi will never bow down to Saudi Arabia. In Pakistan, a Pakistani Muslim will never bow down to Pakistan. It is not a special law for India, because Saudi Arabia is not superior than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Pakistan, the name may be Pak, but it is not superior to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this law is the same. And the concept is that we too love the country. But if it contradicts, for example, in Islam, we consider after Allah and the Messenger, in this world, the person who we respect maximum is our mother. Our mother bore us in a womb for 9 months. We love her. We respect her. We have to die for her. But we can't bow down to her also. When I cannot bow down to my biological mother, where is the question of me to bow down to this land? Why? Because neither my biological mother, neither this land of mine is superior to the Creator. Furthermore, there are 12 lines in the Vande Mataram. 3 is Vande Mataram, which is against Quran and Hadith. Similarly, there are attributes given to Almighty God about Durga, about Lakshmi, about wealth, etc., which contradicts against the concept of Islam. So because it goes against, it is belittling God. So I will not belittle my Creator just for this country. But I love the country. That does not mean that I do not love the country. And this song was written by whom? It was written by Bankim Chakrabartya. For what? It was a political move. And now a few years back, they want to create a century, and they don't even know the date when it is written down. It is more for political motives that the Indian politicians want to make a thing. But these Hindu Indian politicians don't know that they are going against their own Veda by making a political issue. Hope that answers the question.
Thank you, sir.
Yes. I hope the next mic is working. We'll allow 2 questions at that mic, because in the last round it was just being set up. Yes, sister. 2 questions from that mic. First one sister, the sister after that can ask the second question.